Hi everyone, my name is Laura Rodriguez and I am an organic geochemist and data scientist working at the Lunar and Planetary Institute in Houston, Texas. And I am interested in studying the origins of life and in particular how genetic materials could have arisen in abiotic environments on early Earth and other worlds, and also developing techniques to look for life on other worlds, especially ocean worlds. So I got involved when I applied for a postdoc at JPL to work with Dr. Lori Barge. She is the science PI on InVADER. And so when I got that job, I was roped into the project, and that was one of the main projects that I was working on during my time. And originally I'll say that I did my PhD at Penn State, and it was all about origins of life and organic chemistry and lab experiments. And when I was doing that towards the end, I got really more interested in NASA missions because I found that they were really a fascinating way that we can benchmark all the lab stuff that we do. So it's the only real way to go and look to see what are the organics formed on other potentially abiotic, likely abiotic environments. And since that can be the benchmark for laboratory analysis, I got really more into missions, and so that's why I decided to pursue a postdoc at JPL with Lori. So my role has been looking to see, testing the feasibility of using the InVADER payload to explore ocean worlds, and in particular, seeing how well it can characterize the elemental abundance, the organic chemistry, and the mineralogy of deep sea environments, because these techniques have planetary mission heritage. In particular, they're being used on Mars currently, but they've never really actually been tested in situ in the deep sea, and they haven't been tested really on samples that would be relevant for the deep sea environment. So not Mars samples, but things like hydrothermal vent samples or deep sea sediments. And so my work was involved actually going on a cruise a couple of years ago, collecting samples for the team and analyzing those samples using gold standard techniques, as well as analogous techniques to InVADER. So same techniques that InVADER has, but not the actual InVADER payload. To see how well they actually do at characterizing the organic geochemistry and potential biology. I think that one of the most important outcomes is that because ocean world exploration is so tricky, as we see even with exploring our own oceans, having this kind of technique that the InVADER payload has, which basically it can shoot a laser and collect a light that comes back. And because of that, it can do standoff rapid analysis. So it can rapidly shoot its, you know, around the environment and acquire information on the organics and the mineralogy and the elements. And it can do it without having to need to go up to the sample, right? It can do it standoff from like 4 meters, 7 meters away. And so that has a lot of potential for facilitating exploration of the deep sea on Earth, but also other worlds. And for the other worlds in particular, these ocean worlds, they're just so far away that if we were ever to send a submersible to them, we're not going to have the benefit like the Mars missions of getting input from people on Earth, because there's such a delay, a time delay in the communication. So the submersible is going to have to be able to quickly analyze its environment autonomously to really make the most use of its time. So these techniques that InVADER is employing can have a huge impact on how we explore these other worlds.